It's not that I didn't enjoy getting my hands dirty, but this might be my only chance to ride a tractor. I'm not going to pass this one up.
Look at this. Absolutely fantastic. Sitting on top of a great big tractor. Do you know what? I'm nice and comfortable. You know why? It's got springs in my chair. Love it.
This is exactly as much fun as it looks. But now it's time for Cheryl to do her part and offer me that beer.
Nice. Do you know, that was brilliant. I love that.
You look like a professional on the tractor.
I did. I feel like it. I loved it.
I'm so glad you were able to visit
us
tonight.
Well, thank you so much. Yes. I really do appreciate it. Thank you so much. I'm really nice to meet you, Rhett.
Of course.
Well, before you leave this area, and are you thirsty?
I'm a brewer. Of course I'm thirsty, always.
Okay. Well, check out this 559.
I wonder what that was. What's this then?
It's a brewery.
Whose brewer is that then?
It's Rhett's.
You're looking at him.
Way.
To a
Seriously?
Brewer. Yeah.
So you're a brewer?
Exactly.
Hello, Mr. Brewer. I'm Mr. Brewer.
I would love for you to come by, and I would like to treat you to a Raisin Farmer Ale beer after you've been helping me.
Seriously?
With the
Seriously? Yeah. Yes. Say yes. Hold me a spot at the bar. I'll be there later. That's fantastic.
Hold you to it.
Yeah, thank you. And guys, thank you yet again. What a great day. It's been absolutely
thank
wonderful.
You.
I guess she doesn't want the crew getting suspicious because Cheryl threw in a task for me before I could visit her family brewery. She wants me to head down the road to a spring company that's been in Fresno for over 150 years. Best part, it was founded by another Brit. I wonder if he had to work so hard to get a beer.
Ah, look at this. Looks like I'm in the right place. It's fantastic. Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Mike. I've come to see David.
Hi, Mike. David is expecting you. Go on the back.
Thank you very much. Hello, you David?
Welcome, Mike.
Do you know, when I pulled up outside, I was thinking I was going to be going to some old building that's been here for centuries, but actually it's a really modern place, isn't
it? It's nice, isn't it? This is Mike.
Hey, Mike. How you doing? Very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Mike as well, so that's nice and easy. So, what's going on here then? Are these springs that people order?
Yes. People usually send me the requirements, what they would like a spring to do, and I turn it into a design.
That's fantastic. So, I'm really looking forward to having a look around the whole business. Is there any chance you can show me?
Sure. I'll take you outside.
Lovely. No way. Oh, look at this. So there's all that quietness there in the offices. You walk through one door and you get this.
Yeah, quite a difference, isn't it?
That is a difference. That's
incredible. Even with the earplugs, it's loud.
Say that again?
Even with the earplugs, it's loud.
It is loud. So talk me through the process. Where's the first part of spring making?
OK, so we'll take you. We got to go all the way out in the back. You actually see a fire flare up
Let's
over there.
Let's go for it. Yeah, you lead the way.
Springs. All of this for springs. If I wasn't trying to keep my composure in front of the boss, my jaw would be on the floor.
Wow, incredible. I can't believe the size of this place.
All the noise you hear is coming from the ovens that are heating up the springs and cooling them off.
Right, getting them ready to be made. Fantastic, isn't it? Look at it.
Every station has a purpose. And every purpose has a person. A family business that puts food on the tables of families throughout Fresno.
The last 2 years, we've processed about 3.5 million pounds of steel.
Seriously?
Yes.
Whoa! I mean, seriously, this place, look at this. Look. Wow! There's a lot of springs here, isn't there?
Oh, yes.
So this is how you buy it in. You buy the raw material like this in different diameters, and then this, you then run through the forge to turn it into a spring.
Correct.
And is it like you just run it in through in this length?
Oh, no, no. We have to cut this. So what they're doing over here right now is actually picking up the bundle to take it to the saw.
So you buy it in those lengths, and then you bring it here, you have to cut it to a length, do you?
Right. We buy it at 40-foot lengths, then we cut it to size to fit the size spring that we're going to make. Bars get loaded up to be fed into the furnace so they can be heated up for boiling. This oven's running at about 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit.
1,800 degrees?
You can feel the heat coming
off.
Yeah,
you can really feel the heat.
Right.
So once they go into there, do they stay in there for a certain length of time?
Right. Every bar diameter is its own recipe. So the machine controls that time and temperature through the oven before it gets shot out for the spoiling.
So like the larger diameter needs to stay in there longer?
Got to stay in there longer.
Right, yeah. Gotcha.
With the heat and the glow coming off the 1,800 degree steel, it's like watching a man bend a lightsaber into a spring.
So once those coils are done boiling on the mandrel, you drop it in the quench bath, cools off about 200 degrees. It's gonna sit in here until it can be dropped into the tempering furnace. So right here, the parts are too hard to be a spring right now. They'll break.
Right, okay, so now that's been, it's been heated up, quenched off, and it's brittle.
Exactly.
So when does it become a spring?
So we put it into a tempering furnace to warm it back up to soften the material.
So there, it's not a spring,
right,
but by the time it gets to here...
There, it's not a spring.
There, it's not a spring,
right.
But by the time it's gone through there, it's a spring.
That's right.
This all feels a bit like alchemy, like David's got his hands on the Philosopher's Stone. But practical fellow he is, he's turning steel into springs rather than lead into gold. But right now, I want to turn the empty space in my hand into a beer. So it's time for a gracious exit.
Thanks to you and the people here at Fez for showing me around. I really appreciate it.
Certainly. Great to have you here.
No, it's been brilliant. Thanks, I loved every minute of it. That was absolutely fantastic, walking around a Bet Spring Company with David, showing me how a spring is made and put together. That really interesting scientific part in the middle that turns a basic piece of coiled steel into an actual spring that's got a memory. And it's thanks to that that, you know, this old truck is still bouncing down the road. And you can imagine, here in the farming community, this old truck would have been carrying the harvest. Once it was harvested, a bounty would be put into the back of the truck, and even that would be carried in comfort. So I've enjoyed every single minute of that. But now I feel I've worked hard and I deserve to take Cheryl up on her offer and go and visit the family brewery, because I do deserve a nice beer.
This 35 Ford and I have had quite a journey today thanks to Cheryl. There's more history out here in Fresno than meets the eye. And it's thanks to the hard work of the generations of farmers and skilled tradesmen. But now I think the crew is onto me, so I might have to get everyone a pint at Cheryl's Brewery.
And here we go.
Hello, what do we have here?
Look at that. Wow. How straight and clean is that? Proper car. Oh, I like it. I like it a lot.
This is a problem. I can almost taste a beer, but I can't walk past a Mercedes turbo diesel like this without having a proper look. It's almost like a siren singing to me. Buy me, buy me, buy me.
I'm the farm.
I'm all right, Cheryl. Yeah, not bad at all. I'm gonna be honest with you.
Yeah?
My back's hurting a little bit. I've been down bending underneath, cutting those grapes, and it's taking its toll. And I've been driving down here in the old truck that's bouncing along.
Right.
Who's is this?
Oh my gosh, that's our family car.
No way.
Yeah,
seriously.
It was my mom and dad's. It's a 1983 Mercedes diesel. And it was in their barn for 10 years. And they said, hey, Cheryl, if you want the car, you can have it as long as you pick it up. So we turned it on, and all the smoke come barreling out. But you know what? I got in the car, and off we went.
And
you
wanna... the smoke cleared out?
It's cleared out, and I took the car. Would you like to take a look inside?
Can I?
Sure.
Oh,
yes.
Cheryl.
Isn't that a gorgeous car?
Oh, my God, it's like a museum piece.
Yeah, it is.
It's lovely.
All original.
Oh, you need to grow some legs, Cheryl.
Look at it. I had too much tea in London. And it stunted my growth.
Seriously, I've restored one of these in the past, and I've just restored a station wagon as well, or an estate car, and I tell you, they are brilliant. And look at this little secret button in here. Look, it's even so I can remember who my mechanic is. It's got an ant button.
that goes up and an ant button that goes down. I only like the version that goes up. It's very nice.